pero muy cálidas. Esta noche, como repetimos, 75 a 77 grados y continuamos con más del calor. Tengan todos buenas tardes.
¿Siempre has soñado en montarte en un carro nuevo o un carro usado casi nuevo? Sports Mazda de Orlando te lo tiene y sin mucho papeleo. Solo venga con su licencia vigente y sal montado ese verano. Mazda de Orlando, el único dealer con el programa de $49 y sales manejando. Ahora con 37 cooperativas y financieras, haciéndotelo todo más fácil. Llama a Juan Cruz, 407-575-8517. 407-575-8517. Sports Mazda de Orlando y Juan Cruz, sin trucos y sin rodeos. 407-575-8517. Aceptamos todo tipo de crédito. Ciertas restricciones. Restricciones aplican.
Sonido gigante. La primera. Sonido gigante.
La primera.
La primera 1220 y sus auspiciadores no se solidarizan necesariamente con las expresiones vertidas en el siguiente programa.
Assalamu alaikum. This is your host Rashid Mahdi. Welcome to another episode of Islam for Mankind, coming live from La Primera 1220. La Primera 1220. And today, inshallah, we're gonna have a special guest. We're gonna have a guest, Imam Saad Slawi, calling all the way from the beautiful city of Saint Pete. Assalamu alaikum, Imam Saad Slawi.
Wa alaikum assalam, rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alhamdulillah, thank you again for mashallah, for taking your time from your busy time, and also we pray for your daughter for her recovery, inshallah, for her speedy recovery. While we are waiting for Dr. Jesus' arrival, and we know that Imam Saad is multilingual, inshallah, so he's going to do the presentation both in in English and Spanish, inshallah, just so he can catch his breath, and inshallah, we're going to go ahead and inshallah, just redefine or retouch what Islam is for those who are not familiar with the word. Islam is an Arabic word which means peace, submission, and obedience. It is also acceptance and commitment to abide by the teaching and guidance of God. One of the beautiful names, God, is the peace. Islam also means to be at peace with Allah, to be at peace with his creature, to be at peace with all humanity. So everything you hear in the media is not necessarily right. The media have their own agenda, unfortunately, to divide and to create hatred. Most of the media, I'm not saying all of them, so therefore we request from our audience to be open-minded, to be objective, and to also to be fair, to think for themselves, not let the media think for themselves. And to we welcome our audience to ask the Muslims, go find out, you ask your neighbor, go to the mosque and find out what Islam is really is, from the Muslims, rather than hearing a fringe of criminals define what Islam, which is not definitely what you hear from the media. It has nothing to do with Islam. It's all propagated. There is Islamophobia. It's an industry. So without further ado, we go ahead, Imam Saad Slawi. Jazakumullahu khairan.
Jazakumullahu khair. Bueno, primero para nuestros amigos que hablan español, estamos en vivo, en directo desde la primera 1220. Es un placer estar con ustedes otra vez para discutir asuntos de religión, especialmente cosas que tienen que ver con nuestra bella religión del Islam. Y si no quieren llamar, pueden llamar por el 407-343-6001. Es un placer estar con ustedes otra vez. Y bueno, esperando la llegada de nuestro amigo estimado traductor, el doctor Jesús Martí. Inshallah, today we will continue with our series about the true servant of the merciful one. And I will start by saying alhamdulillah, نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. So our dear listeners, it is from the mercy of our Creator, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I used like to work to use the word Allah to call upon the Almighty, the one that created the heavens and the earth for a reason. And a lot of people, if some of you are tuning in with us for the first time and they hear the word Allah, you might be thinking, why isn't he calling him God? And I'll tell you, God, the word God is a very recent word in history. When the English language was created, and the English language is very recent in history, but the proper name of the Almighty, the Creator of the heavens and the earth, is Allah, because even Jesus, the Son of Mary, peace and blessings be upon him, the Prophet and the Messenger whom we love and we respect and we follow, he used to say Allah, Allah. These are the Semitic languages. This is the perfect genderless name, which has monotheism built into it, which literally means the only one worthy of worship. That's why, like I said, Jesus, the Son of Mary, in calling upon the Creator of the heavens and the earth, he would say Allah. We say in Arabic Allah. So Arabic and Aramaic, the language that Jesus, the Son of Mary, spoke, are sister languages. They're very close to each other. And even when the way we say my Lord, we say Ilahi. Jesus said my Lord, he said Elohi or Ilahi, which is the same thing. So these are the Semitic languages, and this is the proper way of calling upon the Almighty, the Creator of the heavens and the earth. Not that we got that out of the way, I will be using the name Allah from here on out, inshallah ta'ala. So it is from his generosity and his mercy that he made it possible for us to have an opportunity and many opportunities to get closer to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to amend our shortcomings that we may have in our acts of worship. And in this particular aspect, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened many, many doors, facilitated many avenues, among which there is one that sits on the top of the list and takes the advantage over all the others. And we are still in our conversation about those special individuals that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the Creator of the heavens and the earth, has mentioned in his glorious book in chapter 25, Surah Al-Furqan. And he described them and he praised them and he called them Ibadur Rahman, the servants of the Most Merciful One. And after we talked about their servitude to Allah, how they are true servants of the Almighty, their humility and their patience and leniency, forbearance with people. And if you remember last time, we mentioned that if someone speaks to them harshly, if they deal with them harshly, if a person mistreats them, what do? They say words of peace and they walk away. They do not engage in any violence. They do not engage in any profanity. They don't raise their voices. These are the true servants of the Almighty that Allah and His Messenger, Muhammad, peace be upon him, wanted us to be like. Allah gave us these descriptions in the Quran, not for us to be entertained, but for us to mimic this behavior. All Muslims are supposed to behave that way. When they see in the face of ignorance, they have to walk away. They walk away from confrontation.
And that's not, Imam Saad, that's really not easy to do. It's easy said than done. Their arrogance take away and things like that. Most people think it's out of weakness. It's not out of weakness. It's out of strength. When you are able to respond and you choose not to because you are commanded by Allah, the Merciful, to forgive, as Imam Saad saying, just to some people say, well, you walk or why you run away from argument or from fight or something like that, but you choose not to because you don't want to lower yourself to that level.
Exactly. That's what I mentioned. If you remember last week when we talked about this particular characteristic, وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا, when the ignorant ones address them harshly, they say peace. They don't do that out of weakness, but they do it out of strength. They do it out of piety, because they know that there is a hereafter and they rather be patient and be rewarded in the hereafter than get into confrontation and then do things that are displeasing to their Lord and Creator. That's what I talked about. If you remember that hadith, لَيْسَ الْقَوِيُّ بِالسُّرَعَ, the Prophet ﷺ said the strong one is not the one that is so hasty to beat people down, but the strong one is the one that is able to control himself in the middle of a fit of rage. That's what strength is all about. And the inshallah today it is characteristic number 6 that we will talk about today inshallah ta'ala. Allah azza wa jalla said, وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا, and the ones that spend their nights to their Lord prostrating and standing. So this is a tremendous act of worship today, and something that today more than ever all of the believers are in need. We're in need of the mercy of our Creator. More than ever we need to get closer to Him. More than ever we need our supplications answered in the midst of all the trials and the tribulations that we're the whole world is going through, in the midst of all the turmoil that all the world is going through, in the midst of all the crimes that are taking place all over the world, and that we can't explain, we don't understand why people are being harmed and people are being, you know, murdered all over the world. This is more than ever we need to get closer to our Creator in supplication.
Mm-hmm. And Imam said, the good news, Dr. Jesus arrived, just give him 10 minutes or 5 minutes to settle down. You can go ahead with the translation while he's catching his breath.
Salaam alaikum there, Imam.
The traffic is getting very, this is the beautiful city of Orlando, is getting more popular and more traffic. Yeah. So
city beautiful, huh?
Yeah, the whole U.S. is beautiful. The whole world is beautiful. Don't let Fox News tell you otherwise. The whole world is beautiful. There is more beautiful people. There is more good than bad, but the media choose only to create a hype and demonize everyone, unfortunately.
Yes, unfortunately. But like I said, we're so in need to get closer to our Lord and Creator in supplication. And He promised and said in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, ayah 186, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Translation, and if my servant asks you, O Muhammad, concerning me, tell them, I am nearby. I answer the invocation of the supplicant if he calls upon me. So let them answer my call and believe in me so that they might be guided. Inshallah, voy a tratar de traducir esperando que el profesional, el doctor Jesús, se prepare. Bueno, que,
sorry, Imam.
lo que dije en inglés que es gracias a la misericordia de Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala en su generosidad, que él hizo posible que los creyentes tengan la oportunidad para obtener más hasanat, buenas obras. Hasanat en árabe que significa buenas obras, para acercarse de él subhanahu wa ta'ala, que es algo bien bien importante, acercarse de su creador, y para reparar las deficiencias que puedan tener en sus actos de adoración. Y en este aspecto particular, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ha abierto muchas puertas para hacerlo más fácil a los creyentes adorarlo, acercarse de él subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pero hay un acto de culto, un acto de adoración que es en esta lista bien grande de tipos de adoración. Eso es de los más superiores, tiene la ventaja sobre la mayoría de los demás, y puesto que todavía estamos hablando y estamos en nuestra conversación sobre aquellas personas especiales que Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ha mencionado en su libro sagrado, en el Corán, y ha descrito de una manera muy muy alta, y los ha llamado Ibad al-Rahman, los servientes del más misericordioso, que Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, de los cuales Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ha hablado mucho en su libro, en el Corán, y Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ha hablado de su servidumbre a Allah, a su humildad, a su indulgencia, a su paciencia, a su tolerancia con las personas. Hoy, inshallah ta'ala, vamos a hablar del tema de Qiyamul Layl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dice en el capítulo 25, la sura 25, el ayah 64, y los que pasan sus noches a su Señor haciendo la prostración y de pie, o sea, adorando a su Señor. Hoy en día, como saben ustedes, más que nunca estamos y tenemos la necesidad y necesitamos más que nunca la misericordia de Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Más que nunca necesitamos estar más cerca de nuestro Creador. Más que nunca necesitamos nuestras súplicas, nuestras súplicas sean respondidas. Eso en el medio de toda la fitna, como se dice en árabe, la fitna, ¿cómo se dice la fitna, doctor Jesús?
Fitna, los pecados, la contaminación.
La tribulación.
Tribulaciones.
A través de los cuales estamos pasando, que vemos a través del mundo entero que los seres humanos hacen daño a otros seres humanos y matan a otros, y no sabemos por qué, no podemos explicar por qué. Mucha, mucha tribulación en el mundo entero. Estamos y necesitamos más que nunca acercarnos de Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah dice en el capítulo 2, que es Surat al-Baqarah, y la aya 186, hablando a su profeta Muhammad, que la paz de Dios sea con él, dice: diles a Muhammad, si mis siervos te preguntas con mi respecto sobre mí, dígale que estoy cerca y respondo a la invocación de los que lo hacen, los que hacen la invocación, y solamente que tienen que responder a mi llamada y tienen que creer en mí. Eso es la única manera para que sean guiados al camino recto. Now, inshallah ta'ala, going back to English, making it a little easier for myself, right? It is.
Thank you, Imam.
It is the. You know, I tried. You're the professional.
No. You do excellent.
Subhanallah, from the true smart believers, it is them that understand to take full advantage of this concept. This concept that gets you closer to the Creator of the heavens and the earth in general, specifically invoking Him in the middle of the night. And there's a hadith that was collected by al-Bukhari and Muslim on the authority of Abu Hurairah. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, "Verily, Allah descends," and listen to this, "descends to the lower heavens in a manner that fits His Majesty in the last third of the night, and He says, 'Who will call upon me so that I will answer his call? Who will ask me so I can give him what he's asking for? Who seeks my forgiveness so that I would forgive him?'" So obviously this is an act of worship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to do, and He made it mandatory for the prophets and the messengers. And we have to understand this concept. Every single prophet or messenger, it was mandatory for them to stand at night and pray. And alhamdulillah, Allah did not make it mandatory for us, especially nowadays that our crazy schedules and people believe in the number eight. You know, you need those 8 hours, everyone says. But subhanallah, it is something that is voluntary, but it's something tremendous. If someone wants to get closer to his Creator and make supplication for himself, for his family, and for the whole world that is going crazy, this is the time. This is the time to make supplication to the Creator of the heavens and the earth. And this is a true proof of Iman. It is a proof of faith. It is a proof of devotion to the Creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a proof to the connection with Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a proof of the fear and the love that we should have for our Creator. And when I say the love, of course, the love is clear, but when it comes to fear, some people don't understand this concept. It is fear to disappoint, fear of, you know, not being loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you don't know. It's a matter of the unseen. You do your best for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love you back as well, which the ones that do this, that have this characteristic, the Almighty, the Creator of the heavens and the earth, called them Ibadur Rahman. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you and I from them. Amen. Allah said in Surah Al-Zariyat, chapter 51, ayah number 17, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونٍ آخِذِينَ مَا آتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ مُحْسِنِينَ كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون. The Almighty said, indeed, the righteous will be among the gardens and springs, meaning they'll be in paradise, accepting what their Lord has given to them. Indeed, they were before that, they were doers of good. Why? Why were they doers of good? Why were they described as doers of good? كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون. They were very, very rarely you will find them sleeping at night. Very, very, very rarely you'll find them sleeping at night. وبالأسحار, الأسحار, this is the plural of سحر, which is the time right before Fajr, and right at that time of سحر, they were doing istighfar. They were sitting and seeking the forgiveness of their Lord, saying, Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah.
Dr. Jesus? Unfortunately, people now, they are staying late, but they are chasing Pokemon, and they are... Some of them don't even sleep. They're not thinking the Creator of the heavens, who created them, who provide for them, who the oxygen, does anything we take for granted, the air that we breathe, everything that we see and we don't see is a gift from Allah. The least we can do is be thankful and appreciate what we have, and absolutely, be thankful.
Absolutely.
Go ahead, Dr. Jesus.
We get distracted from the essence. nos dice, querido Imam Sata, primero, de que los verdaderos creyentes y los creyentes que son sabios son aquellos que están constantemente siempre orando y suplicándole a ese adorado y a ese fiel creador de todo el universo. También nos trae un hadith bajo la autoridad de Abu Herrera, quien dice que aquel que también, que Allah nos dice que él está pendiente de día y de noche, de aquel que esté pendiente a estarle suplicando, a estarle orando, y que él está presto a darle su contestación, y está pendiente de aquellos que están pidiendo y suplicando su perdón para este también concedérselos. Allah no hace estas cosas así de forma mandatoria. Es importante que nosotros hagamos las súplicas por iniciativa propia y para el bienestar nuestro y de nuestras propias familias y seres queridos. Esto es una prueba de nuestro imam. Nos dice también el Imam Saad, de que nos cita el sura número 51 a la ley 10, bueno, en español desde la 15 hasta la 18, es el sura de los que levantan un torbellino. Nos dice, los que hayan sido temerosos estarán en jardines y en manantiales, recibiendo lo que su Señor les dé. Antes habían hecho el bien, era poco lo que dormían de noche, y en el tiempo anterior al alba pedían su perdón. Vemos lo bonito, vemos como este sura recoge todos estos comentarios que nos dice Imam Zad, aquellos que han sido temerosos, aquellos que han tenido ese temor, el taqwa, o sea, hacia Dios Padre Todopoderoso, van a estar en los jardines y en los manantiales, y recibiendo lo que su Señor les dé, y antes se dedicaban a hacer el bien. ¿Cuál era el bien? Pues dormían poco de noche, y en el tiempo anterior al alba ya estaban suplicando su perdón. Imam Zad, Jazakumullah
Khairan. For those who just join us, this is your weekly radio program, Islam for Mankind. We can be reached live at 407-343-6001. 407-343-6001. Imam Zad, can you say that number in Spanish, please, so that way for our audience?
Oh, yo se lo digo.
407-343-6001.
Eso.
Proceed.
I still remember how to say the numbers, right?
Certainly, perfect.
Alhamdulillah. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has mentioned that the real people of Iman being faith and belief, are the people of Qiyamul Layl, the ones that pray at night. Allah ta'ala said in Surah Al-Sajda, which is chapter 32, ayah number 16. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Innama yu'minu bi ayatina alladhina idha dhukkiru biha kharru sujjadan wa sabbahu bihamdi rabbihim wa hum la yastakbirun. تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع يدعون ربهم خوفا وطمعا ومما رزقناهم ينفقون فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين جزاء بما كانوا يعملون. Translation, Allah Ta'ala said, and only those that believe in all verses, who when they are reminded, when they are reminded of the verses and the signs of Allah, they fall down in prostration and exalt Allah with praise to their Lord, and they are not arrogant. They arise from their beds, they supplicate their Lord in fear and aspiration, and from what we provided them they spend, and no soul knows what has been hidden, what has been concealed for them of comfort to their eyes as a reward for what they used to do. It was collected by Al-Bukhari with authority from Abu Hurairah. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, Allah said, this is a hadith Qudusi, hadith ilahi, a divine hadith. Allah said, I have prepared for my pious worshippers such things that no eye has ever seen and no ear has ever heard and nobody has ever thought of. All that is reserved besides which all you have seen is nothing. Then the Prophet recited, no soul knows what is kept hidden in reserve for them as joy, as reward for what they used to do, which is chapter 32, ayah number 17. Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, one of the big scholars of Islam, he said, let us contemplate upon or ponder upon the fact that Allah rewarded them for what they concealed from the others. And this is very important, because the night prayer is something that you do, it's just you and Allah. There's nobody looking at you. It's something that you do, you've concealed from others. It's a private thing that you do. Only Allah knows about it. He said that he rewarded them from what they concealed from the others, from their night prayer, by reserving hidden bounties that no one has seen before in the hereafter, that are exclusive for them. And the lack of security and fear that they might have felt away from their beds at night, by giving them complete security and joy in Al-Jannah. So beautiful. Dr. Jesus.
Nos dice Imam Zad también de que Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nos dice también que menciona que las verdaderas personas que tienen imam son aquellos que están y se mantienen en rezo, en oración nocturna. Nos trae también a colación el sura número 32, a la aleya número 16. Este es el sura de la postración. Entonces Vamos en la versión en español, es en la aleya número 15. Solo creen en nuestros signos aquellos que cuando se les menciona caen postrados. Glorifican a su Señor con las alabanzas que les son debidas y no tienen soberbia. Levantan su costado de los lechos para invocar a su Señor con temor y anhelo y dan de la provisión que le damos. Vemos que bonito eso, cómo es que solo aquellos que le creen en los signos que nos da ese Padre amado, ese Dios Todopoderoso, el Creador de todo el universo, son aquellos que siempre los mencionan y cuando lo están mencionando caen postrados. Lo glorifican siempre y lo alaban y tienen siempre sus debidas atenciones y no son soberbios. Acuérdense que la soberbia es castigada, tenemos que aprender a ser humildes, hermanos. Nos dice también bajo la autoridad de Abu Herrera, el hadith nos dice de que Allah nos dice de que este ha preparado para sus adoradores más piadosos, más compasivos y más devotos aquellas cosas que jamás ni nunca nosotros hemos soñado con poder ver. Así que podemos nosotros contemplar las cosas que tiene guardada y esas bienaventuranzas que vamos a recibir, que van a ser de uso exclusivo para aquellos que han estado siempre en adoración adecuada al Creador. Imam Sad, yo saco la jugada.
Si no puede traducir lo que dijo Ibn al-Qayyim,
¿cuál?
Si es posible. Si quiere, lo hago yo. Ibn al-Qayyim dijo que contemplamos en el hecho de que Dios los recompensa por lo que han ocultado de los demás de su oración de la noche, a reservar compensas ocultas que nadie ha visto antes, que dice el jazá min jins el amal, porque ellos han hecho actos de adoración y los ocultaron de los demás. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lo va a recompensar con le va a dar recompensas ocultas que nadie ha visto antes en el más allá, que son exclusivos para ellos, y la falta de seguridad, el temor que han sentido fuera y lejos de sus camas por la noche, dándole el Señor los va a dar la seguridad completa y la alegría completa en el paraíso.
Okay, gracias.
And also just a side note as well, just to show that Islam, there is more common ground between Islam and other faith for those who like, for our brothers and sisters in other faith, we can find there is a similarity between Islam in prostration and also did Jesus perform this, and the answer is yes. It can be found in Matthew 26 verse 39, which said, going a little farther, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me, yet not as I will, but as you will." So here we see that Jesus himself, may peace and blessing be upon him, did pray as the Muslim pray, did prostrate to the creator of the heavens and the earth. You see, not my will, but that will, the will of his creator, which is Allah. So this is just a side note. So some people, you know, when they see there is more similarities, but people are always thinking, oh, look at the Muslims, how they do that. So by prostrating to your creator, by recognizing our weakness, by you come closer to your creator. That was just a side note. Dr. Jesus, if you want to translate, and we'll go back to Imam Saad, inshallah.
Sorry, my pleasure. Dice el hermano Rashid también de que una similaridad que son bien importantes, que tenemos que tener a colación y traer, tomarlos en consideración, es cuando hablamos del tema de la prostración. Esto él hace alusión también al profeta Jesús, paz y bendiciones de Dios sean con él siempre, y nos hace alusión al Mateo, capítulo 26, al verso número 39, y nos dice ahí también de que Jesús oraba, y también en Marcos capítulo 14 y versículo número 35 nos dice de que Jesús también se postraba cada vez que éste iba a adorar. En el aspecto del Mateo 26:39 fue cuando Jesús estaba en el jardín de los olivos y este estaba, hace alusión de que estaba en prostración y solicitándole a Dios que pasara esa copa, no como él lo deseaba, sino como Dios así lo deseaba. Vemos que las escrituras pues, nos enseñan las diferentes maneras, o sea, y las similaridades que tenemos, que es bien, bien, bien importante. Nosotros seguimos adorando, seguimos rezando tal y como los profetas. Nosotros imitamos a lo que los profetas pues nos enseñaron, y antes de profeta Mohammed pues había estado en la tierra pues, el profeta Jesús. Vemos que este rezaba como nosotros los musulmanes en la práctica pues lo hacemos todo aún en la actualidad, y que son muchas más las similaridades. Al estar nosotros postrados pues demostramos nuestra humildad, renunciamos a nuestra soberbia y adoramos al Creador. Y Imam Saad o Rashid,
Imam Saad, go ahead.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also revealed that the people that pray at night are the ones that are truly concerned about the matter of the hereafter. They are the ones that truly seek the mercy of their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Az-Zumar 39 and ayah number 9, Allah ta'ala says, أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا وَقَائِمًا يَحْذَرُ الْآخِرَةَ وَيَرْجُو رَحْمَةَ رَبِّهِ قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Translation, the ones that is one, Allah is asking a question, a rhetorical question, is one who is devoutly obedient during periods of the night, prostrating and standing in prayer, fearing the hereafter and hoping for the mercy of his Lord, like one who does not, say, are those who know equal to the ones that do not know? Only they will remember the ones who are people of understanding. So praying at night is one of the is the way of the righteous. It is the way of the prophets and the messengers. It is the way that Allah commanded his messengers, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to stand and pray at night. He has, as I mentioned before, it was the before the salah, the five daily prayers that we have now as Muslims were mandatory. That's what was mandatory for the Prophet, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And as you know, the night prayer or the five daily prayers, they were not ordained until the night of the Ascension. And we see this in Surah Al-Muzzammil, which is chapter 73. Ayah 1 to 4, Allah Ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal muzzammil, qum al-layla illa qalila, nisfahu aw inqus minhu qalila, aw zid alayhi wa rattil al-Qur'an tartila. Allah said, oh, who wraps himself in clothing, the one that is sleeping and being wrapped, arise to pray the night, except for a little, half of it, or subtract from it a little, or add to it, and recite the Quran with measured recitation. And Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Al-Isra as well, Surah Al-Isra is 17, and the ayah is 79. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَتَهَجَّدْ بِهِ نَافِلَةً لَكَ عَسَىٰ أَن يَبْعَثَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. And Allah says, and from part of the night, pray with it, with the Qur'an meaning, and as additional worship for you, it is expected that your Lord will resurrect you in a praised manner or a praised station. And Aisha radiallahu anha, the wife of the Prophet, may Allah be pleased with her, she said that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said three things were made mandatory for me and are only a sunnah, meaning a voluntary act of worship, for the rest of you. He says witr salah, and a siwak, and the night prayer. Witr salah is the third rak'ah that we pray every night after al-isha, a Siwak is the scientific name is Salvadora persica. It is a special tree that you can cut small pieces off the branches, and it's excellent for cleaning the mouth and cleaning the teeth, and the night prayer, which is clear. And Allah Ta'ala also said in Surah Al-Insan, which is Surah number 76, the ayah 26, وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَاسْجُدْ لَهُ وَسَبِّحْهُ لَيْلًا طَوِيلًا. And during the night, prostrate to him and exalt him a long part of the night. Dr. Jesus.
Yo sé cómo la juguera. Nos dice, Imam Sante, que Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala nos habla del más allá y nos trae a colación también cuando Él nos dice que es como una cuestión voluntaria, pero que es algo que en verdad es de gran enriquecimiento, que le adoremos en las noches, y que en la oposición, por el contrario, pues para los profetas era más bien una cuestión mandatoria. Nos trae a colación Imam Sante también el Surah número 39, a la aleya número 9, y citamos del sagrado libro: ¿acaso quien se entrega a la adoración en las horas de la noche, postrado y en pie, ocupándose de la última vida y esperando la misericordia de su Señor? Di, ¿son iguales los que actúan así o los que sí actúan? Solo recapacitarán los que saben reconocer lo esencial. Vemos que ahí nos dice, en una pregunta retórica, ¿son iguales los que lo hacen a los que no lo hacen? Pues la contestación es obvia, hermanos. Si lo hacemos, pues vemos que nos distinguimos y ocupamos un lugar excelso, un lugar de excelencia. También nos traía a colación Imam Sad el Surah número 73, a las aleyas 1 y 4. Surah 73, a las aleyas número 1 y 4. De la 1 a la 4, perdón. Citamos del Sagrado Libro también. Estamos buscando aquí en el libro porque se nos extravió. Nos dice en el Sagrado Libro también, el Sura 73, de la ley número 1 hasta la 4. Estamos aquí ubicándonos, perdónanos, Imam Sad. 7.1, 7.2, 7.3, a leyes 1 hasta la 4. Nos dice: o tú que te envuelves en el manto, permanece rezando por la noche a excepción de un poco. Aquí vemos que le dice, hace alusión, hay una anotación en el Sagrado Libro del Corán donde dice, hay alusión al profeta, que Alá le da su gracia y su paz, el cual al regreso de su primer encuentro con Jibril, con el arcángel Gabriel, al comienzo de la revelación, le pidió a su esposa Hadija que lo envolviera con un manto, con un intento de mitigar su excitación y sobrecogimiento. Entonces dice también: o tú que te envuelves en el manto, la mitad o algo menos, o algo más, y recita el Corán pausadamente. Realmente vamos a depositar en ti palabras de peso, y en el seno de la noche hay mayor quietud y es más certera la dicción. Vemos lo que nos dice el mismo Creador, de que de la noche hay mucho más quietud, nos podemos concentrar más y nuestra dicción también se mejora. O sea que en la recitación pues podemos mejorar mucho. Yo no sabía eso, Imam Sad. eso es un beneficio extraordinario.
Also, just like to remind, because the media is dividing people, so we need to remind all humanity that Muslims and non-Muslims, like Muslims, Christians, and Jews, are all trace their origin to the Prophet Abraham, and the three a direct descendant from Abraham's son. So Muhammad, peace be upon him, is from the eldest Ishmael, and Moses and Jesus from Isaac, peace be upon all of them. So therefore, we Muslims, we believe in all the prophets, we love and we believe in Jesus, we believe in all the prophets with no exceptions. So a Muslim never mention the name Jesus without saying peace be upon him. So the Quran confirm his virgin birth, and the special chapter of the Quran is entitled Mary, in honor of the mother of Jesus, Virgin Mary. This is to share this because why? Because the media right now, especially in the president election, some people are dividing the people, are demonizing Islam and Muslim, and they are doing that also by and justice anywhere is injustice everywhere, and demonizing one religion is demonizing all of them. So we should respect each other. Everyone is free to believe whatever they want to, but it is not right to demonize each other. We are, as Imam said, we are the listeners who are living in a social group, and it is in our best interest that we should cooperate. I don't want to take much time. Go ahead, Dr. Imam Saad. Jazakumullahu khairan.
But this is whether this segment would be a call to all the ones that can hear us right now. If you can hear us and you are a believer, you are someone that worships the Almighty alone without taking any partners with Him, you are from the people of At-Tawheed, you should feel fortunate and you should feel proud that the Almighty gave you this honor to worship Him alone without taking any partners with Him, that He bestowed upon you this bounty of guidance, and that you are someone that is steadfast with his prayer, someone that attends, that goes to the houses of Allah to pray and to prostrate and to bow. You should feel so fortunate. And this is something that the prophets and the messengers, especially Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, showed clearly how proud and how grateful he was for the bounty of the guidance. This hadith was collected by Al-Bukhari on the authority of Aisha. She said that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he would stand in prayer at night until his feet would crack. And so Aisha would tell him, "Why are you doing this to yourself? Why, Allah has already forgiven all your sins, past and the future." So he said something amazing. أَفَلَا أَكُونُ in another narration, أَفَلَا أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. He said, shouldn't I be a grateful servant? Shouldn't I be a grateful servant for the bounties that he gave me? SubhanAllah. So قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ, standing in prayer at night, is one of the ways to enter paradise, to enter al-Jannah. It was collected by Ibn Majah on the authority of Abdullah ibn Salam. Abdullah ibn Salam, by the way, was a Jewish rabbi that became a Muslim in the time of the Prophet. So he became a companion of the Prophet, and he was actually one of the biggest scholar of all the Jews of Medina, and he became a Muslim, and he was a companion of the Prophet, peace be upon him. He said when Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, came to Medina, the people rushed to meet him, and it was said, the Messenger of Allah has come, the Messenger of Allah has come, the Messenger of Allah. They were saying that three times. And I came with the people to see him. And when I saw him, this and this happened when he was still on his Jewish faith and he was a Jewish rabbi. He said, I came to with the people to see him. And when I saw him, when I saw his face clearly, I knew that his face was not the face of a liar. The first thing I heard him say, he said, the first thing I heard him say when he talked to the people, he said, "Oh people, spread the greeting of peace, spread the greeting of salam, and feed others, and uphold the ties of kingship, and pray during the night when people are sleeping, and you will enter paradise in peace." SubhanAllah.
I'm glad you mentioned that. Also, Prophet Muhammad said to Ibn Abdullah, as a covenant to those who adopt Christianity near and far, we are with them. Verily, I, the servant, the helper, and my follower, defend them, because Christians are my citizen, and by God, I hold out against anything that displeases them. No compulsion is to be on them, neither are the judges to be removed from their jobs, nor the monk from the monastery. No one, and I put the emphasis in, no one is to destroy a house of religion or damage it. We've seen some misguided people right now, I mean, harming places of worship or to church, or harming church or anything like that. This is a prophet of mercy. This is Prophet Muhammad, may peace and blessing be upon him, saying as a covenant, if you truly, anyone who truly believe in Islam and the Quran and truly believe in Muhammad as the last and final messenger, this is the message from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, stating that we should preserve, not destroy. We should, you know, be a mercy to all mankind. And this is very important. We're going to give the mic to Dr. Jesus to translate, and inshallah we shall continue.
Se nos dice también, nos decía Imam Sand, que esto es una llamada para los escuchas, eres de la gente, para los radioescuchas, y eres de la gente que tiene Tawhid, que es, crees en la unicidad de Dios, es uno, único, y el Dios verdadero. Siéntete honrado que Dios te da este conocimiento y que permite que le adores y que te libres de tu soberbia. Nos trajo también a colación hace un rato Imam Sand el Sura 17, el Sura del Viaje, a la ley 79, y dice, citamos del Sagrado Libro, y ve la parte de la noche como un acto voluntario para ti, puede que tu Señor te eleve a una estación digna de alabanza. Y también el Sura 76, a la Aleya 26, y nos dice el Sagrado Libro, y por la noche póstrate ante él glorificándolo un largo periodo de ella. Es cierto que estos aman la vida fugaz, dejando a sus espaldas un día grave. Él nos menciona también, Imam Sand, que el profeta Muhammad solía orar en la noche hasta que sus pies sonaban y su esposa le cuestionaba, y este respondía que tenía que ser un siervo al estar postrándose y levantándose y postrándose y levantándose. Su esposa le decía, ¿por qué haces eso si Dios ya te ha perdonado tus pecados por tus oraciones? Y este le respondía que él tenía que ser el ejemplo de lo que es un siervo agradecido. Un escolar judío también en Medina nos decía de que la gente corría a conocerlo cuando llegó el profeta hasta allí, y este fue con la gente a verlo, y al ver su cara, este dijo y este expresó que su cara le denotaba de que este no mentía. Y al llegar el profeta, las primeras cosas que dijo fue, den un mensaje de paz a todos los que ustedes vean, den comida al que no la tiene, al menos favorecido, y oren siempre por las noches. También nos dice también que nos dice también de que como cuestión de respeto para otras fe, fue un pacto que hizo el profeta, y que él decía que todos aquellos que practicaran el cristianismo, ya fuera allí o en otras tierras lejanas, que lo iban a respetar, que también todos los servidores y los ayudantes y sus seguidores tienen que defenderlos a ellos, defender a los cristianos, porque los cristianos eran sus ciudadanos, y pues, y defenderlos también en nombre de Dios, que no podía hacerse nada en contra de ellos, tenían su derecho a adorar y adorar en sus capillas, en sus iglesias, y que los musulmanes iban a pelear por ellos y los iban a defender. Si una dama cristiana se casaba con un caballero musulmán, esto no iba a ocurrir si no mediaba primero el consentimiento de la misma, y que no se iba a prohibir visitas a las
we
iglesias.
We thank Station La Maica 1220 for allowing us to do the show. We thank Dr. Jesus Marti for translation, and we thank Imam Sad for taking time from his busy schedule. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam
wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.